Many families have faced the harsh reality of placing a loved one in a nursing home.
You worry about their health, happiness, and their safety. Would cameras put concerns at ease? News 4 investigator Lauren Traeger explores that idea tonight and finds that it is facing serious opposition in Missouri.
Yeah, I love the way he looked in this picture.
In her St. Louis home, Martha Udaly looks at pictures of her husband of 52 years, Tom. They're much preferred to the images in her memory.
Every time I see that picture in my mind, it's like it was yesterday.
Due to failing health several years ago, Tom entered a local nursing home. On a visit, Martha says she noticed a gruesome smell.
I pushed on the door and it opened and he was sitting in his wheelchair, head down, lifeless.
Tom, she says, had been horribly neglected.
The feces within his pants broke through and ran down the sides of the chair.
Riddled with bed sores and spiking fevers, she says he was hospitalized but never recovered.
Is there any doubt in your mind that it was neglect?
Not at all. Not at all.
Martha, still overcome with emotion,
but for the grace of God, that could be you,
says she never imagined it would happen to him.
It's just heartbreaking to me. Just heartbreaking that people can't understand.
But she says one thing could have made the difference. A camera inside her husband's room.
Oh, I know it would have, because I would have seen everything that was happening.
Stop.
It's shocking. I could not believe what my eyes seen.
At a nursing home in the Detroit area, a suspicious son planted a camera.
I decided to get solid evidence and hard evidence.
Sure enough, video captured the nearly 90-year-old man being thrown, slapped, and berated.
Horrible, unspeakable verbal and physical abuse. Torture. I mean, this was a living hell for this gentleman.
The family sued in that case. Other video from around the country depicting horrifying acts of abuse. But in those instances, they often used hidden cameras. Advocates say they'd like residents to have the choice. Cameras out in the open.
When you look at society today, cameras are really everywhere.
Mary Lynn Fonda Donovan is with Voice, an advocacy group for residents in long-term care facilities. She says a recording in progress sign inside a resident's room could prevent abuse and neglect.
I think they would just have a greater sense of security if they were able to check on their loved one every so often and just monitor their care, because family members just cannot be there 24 hours a day.
Right now, under Missouri law, a resident of a nursing home could be kicked out if a facility finds a camera. Donovan wants a law that protects the rights of residents.
The key thing is the resident has control over that camera and when it's on and when it's off.
10 other states, including Illinois, have already passed what have become known as granny cam laws.
I think it's time for Missouri to take a hard look on whether this also should be an important tool that is available to residents and their family members.
Right now, two proposed bills in Jefferson City address the issue. One leaves it up to the facility to decide if cameras will come in. The other leaves it up to the resident. But the nursing home industry is strongly opposing it.
This is just more regulations being piled onto a already overregulated industry.
Keith Sappington with the Missouri Assisted Living Association says they're against any bill that mandates a resident's right to a camera. They've worried about privacy concerns or additional lawsuits.
We were concerned that electronic monitoring, what type of equipment is being put in residents' rooms, where is that feed going, who is looking at that feed, is it going to become a HIPAA violation.
Instead, they want it left up to each facility.
Do you think they've got a compelling argument?
No, I don't.
But Representative Jim Murphy doubts any nursing home would allow a camera.
I think it's up to the patient. And the families, they're the ones that we're trying to protect, not the nursing homes.
Why are people so afraid of change? Make these people accountable for what they do.
Martha, grateful for Murphy's bill, says Missouri must take action.
Unless we do something, this could be your mother, this could be your father, this could be your child.
To protect our loved ones from tragedy.
There's too much of it that goes on. every day, day in, day out.
Martha did not want to name the nursing home in her husband's case because she says she was too distraught at the time to take any legal action against them. Now, the legislative session ends next week, so it's unlikely either bill will pass this time, but it's certainly not the last we've heard of the issue. If you want to contact your lawmaker about it, we've got links for you on KMOV.com. I'm Lauren Traeger, News 4 Investigates.